You would be passing the famous church of St. Constantine and St. Methodius, which is very important for the World War II history, because the soldiers who assassinated Reinhard Heydrich, the German Deputy Reich Protector and the Nazi number 3 in Germany, were hiding after the assassination in the church. Otherwise, you can also see the water towers next to the river. They were built in the 16th, 17th century, and from these towers water was pumped to the fountains and water reservoirs all around the city. Driving along the river, we are also passing some of the islands. There are 8 islands in total on the river, and nowadays all of them are designed to serve as an entertainment and a relaxing place for Prague citizens. We are passing one of the islands called the Children Island, because there are playgrounds for kids. Within a few moments, we are going to stop at the Legia Bridge. It's, by the way, the second oldest bridge. It's quite interesting detail. In the half of the 14th century, it was built the Charles Bridge, and it was the only bridge in Prague until the half of the 19th century. Then, thanks to the Industrial Revolution, the traffic increased, so there were 2 other chain bridges built in Prague. But the chain construction wasn't very happy, so at the end, approximately 12-15, depending on the situation, at the Old Town Square, there will be the promised little break for refreshment, next toilet break, or for buying some souvenirs. And those who would like to return back to the bus and back to the hotel will set up the meeting place, so to stay in the afternoon in the city. It's no problem, you can stay there, but please, in that case, don't leave anything in the bus. Yeah, think about what you are going to do. If you'd like to return back to the hotel, you can again leave some of the...
The old days, rather than house numbers, they identified them by symbols or pictures over the door. This was the house of the Blue Wolf. This is not an island. Okay, we're entering the St. Charles Bridge.
Generally, in the Middle Ages, it was quite typical for the political marriages. You was engaged in that age of the French Princess Blanche, when they were married when they were 9. This is something which survives from the communistic regime, or generally even during the period of the Czechoslovak Republic, before the war by the second, the university studies were not charged. Are very old. They looked most like 300 years old, being designed in a Baroque style, but the inner walls are, for example, Gothic from 14th century. Because during the reconstruction, they were always trying to save as much money as possible. So they were trying to keep whatever was possible to keep to save the money.
This is Old Town Square. I'm being chased by a roller. Okay, this is the Museum of Communism at Prague. Okay, go up the steps.
Down there they have an angry nesting doll. You see that? This is the poster. Can you see it? No? Okay, you can go it up.
It's warm up here. It's warm up here.
This just talks about the origins of Czechoslovakia. one big hook there.
Mm-hmm.
Right there.
Mm-hmm. These photos show how the city center was allowed to disintegrate. So this is where they end. Yeah, oh, yes. It's the church.
Music, but in Prague.
Thank you. About the dulcimer. There are many theories as to the history of dulcimer. One of them is that it originates in old China. In the medieval times, came to